Martin Turner's Wishbone Ash about to play Progbury, and they're out there. In fact, Life Begins tour has been going on for some time. Martin, when exactly does Life Begin then?
Well, obviously, the title of the tour is taken from Life Begins at 40, and I'm not actually 40 at the moment. I'm, what am I, 36 and dyslexic.
Oh, yeah, that sounds fine.
No, obviously, Wishbone Ash has existed for 40 years, basically, is what that's all about. We've been calling the Life Began tour. But the official title is the Life Begins tour.
Well, life is beginning, doesn't it? What do you think it is that keeps the music of Wishbone Ash very much alive in people's hearts?
What do you think it is, are you saying?
Yeah.
I think that we are fairly unusual in that we have sold records consistently throughout the period, you know, the history of the band at a pretty prodigious rate. And it would appear that the music has what you would call a long shelf life. Maybe that's because it's not kind of gimmicky and commercial. You know, like it's not I'm Too Sexy for My Shirt, which is a great record. I mean, I know Fred and Richard really well. I've worked with them. But it's one of those things that seems to, you know, people go really big on it for 10 minutes or a couple of months, and then all of a sudden it gets dropped forever after. Whereas our music seems to be less commercial, but as people discover it, they really take it to their hearts, and it seems to last for a very long time, possibly because of the melodic content. Although it's rock music, it does have a lot of melody in it.
There seems to be a resurgent in progressive music and people's appreciation of it. Would you put that down completely to Wishbone Ash?
Well, no, I couldn't really claim credit for that. Surely not. But
we'd let you.
Yeah, I think maybe, you know, music shifts in periods all the time, and you had the new romantic, you know, the synthesizer generation, dance music, the 90s. It's people have been making music on computers for a long time now. Computers, sequencers, keyboards. And gradually people have discovered and realized that actually there is something incredibly attractive about what I refer to as organic music, where you've got a bunch of guys that actually play instruments together, because that was beginning to kind of fade away for a while. But I think particularly a lot of young people have kind of looked back to that period and thought, well, wait a minute, you know, the music that we've got now, which is very electronic and perfect and all the rest of it, is actually maybe not as good as that old music in certain respects. So there has been a reawakening in recent years, yes.
Which is nice to know. You re-recorded Argos just to, you know, bring it out there with Martin Turner's Wishbone Ash. What have you got planned for the future?
We are trying desperately to get into the studio and start recording a brand new album. Most of the material exists already, but I've been finding it extremely difficult to get everyone together. Well, certainly, you know, my time, I mean, it just seems to be so hectic and busy nowadays. But we do have a period where we're off to Europe for a month, and it's bang bang every day, you know, it's crazy. And I believe there's only one gig in December, which is a fairly important one, a package with Argent and Curved Air.
Fantastic.
And ourselves. But other than that, the run-up to Christmas is fairly clear, although having said that, my wife is involved in a business, you know, alternative medicine, Neil's Yard Remedies, which traditionally is always absolute madness at that period of the year. But I'm hoping that we can maybe do some recording before Christmas and maybe some more afterwards. We'll have to see. I hope so, because it is high time that we made a new record.
Yeah, something exciting to look forward to in the spring, perhaps, then.
That would be great, wouldn't it? That would be really good, hopefully. I mean, I have been working with the other guys, the video crew, on the DVD editing and sound, which is scheduled for release as soon as possible. Hopefully, well, I don't think it will be on this tour that we're doing of the UK, But that, you know, in practical terms, I mean, I guess that will be the spring when we tour now before that DVD comes out, although it may be available on the website between now and then.
All right, well, that's something to look out for then.
Yeah.
Anybody attending Progbury this weekend, you're playing there on the Sunday evening, what can we expect from your set?
Well, I'm a bit baffled. They've got the times they sent me down with 75 minutes, but that's with everyone back to back, so presumably there would need to be a 15 or 20 minute trick changeover unless they're using two stages. So I'm not that well informed. I know that, is it mostly Autumn are on before us, and Hawk Lord, that's it. I was going to say Hawk Wind, but it's a variation. Yeah, Hawk Lord are on after us. That's about all I know, really, but it sounds like it could be a jolly good event.
It does indeed, and we shall look forward to seeing you in Suffolk on Sunday. Have a great gig tonight, because I know that you've got a sound check that you've got to do. Martin Turner, Wishbone Ash, it's great talking to you. Thank you so much.
Okay, Sue, thanks very much. Lovely, lovely.